Yes. Only together can we defeat him.
I will not fail you, my master.
Star Wars, Star Wars, Star Wars. There aren't many more franchises in existence that have been beaten more to death than Star Wars. It's like a sad undead horse that's been lashed into oblivion. No, check that. Like a dopey ass Ewok that's been stripped of its rear and spanked by Uncle Chewbacca. Star Wars The Force Unleashed delivers possibly one of the most hyped up gaming experiences of 2008. And there is no real good reason for it. These games typically have a 1 in 20 chance of being merely halfway decent. The game is still somehow so overhyped that it's appearing in Time Magazine's top 10 of the year for some on Jedi-like reason. It's pretty ridiculous. So The Force Unleashed tells the story of Starkiller, whose parents have been killed while he was still a small child. He becomes Darth Vader's secret apprentice and newest write-in to the Star Wars universe. As Starkiller, you start off obeying the evil Sith orders, unquestionably assassinating whoever he describes, good or evil. Seems Darth Vader has his own agenda going on, taking out whoever may oppose him to become the new Lord of the Galaxy, ousting that old coot Emperor Palpatine. Of course, things don't go entirely according to plan, and you aren't playing as some evil mindless drone the entire time. Starkiller, who's still showing small shreds of emotion throughout the cutscenes, starts to grow a mind of his own, while meanwhile, Darth isn't having the greatest luck keeping his plans all on the down low either. For a Star Wars action game storyline, it's rather well done. The cutscenes are thankfully well reserved and do a good job at hinting potential emotion rather than overdoing it with crying and angst. If you still haven't changed your Star Wars bedsheets, you'll probably have a blast. In terms of that important stuff known as gameplay, Unleashed really needed, another year or two more in development. The fighting's clunky and a bit obtuse. Mashing your way through some of these levels becomes a grind. The brutal elegance in games like God of War or Ninja Gaiden is sadly not present. It's pretty much a small step below even Heavenly Sword. It's not exactly wretched, but it does feel heavily rushed. Everything just lacks a slight bit of polish, which is sort of difficult to describe individually, but then it all adds up. Like, everything is never quite specifically how it should be. Enemies have this agitating way of spawning right in front of you. Combat sometimes feels a little jerky. There's an over-reliance on action button sequences. It's difficult to have your skills perform precisely as you want them to, and so on. The biggest thing being hyped about this game is that you are actually in control of the Force, something that has been failed time and time again, and why none of the existing decent Star Wars games already made have anything to do with lightsaber swinging. The Force Unleashed is the one that promised to make it work. On some levels, it even kind of succeeds. When you first start out, the Force Blast is a kick-ass move. It gives you a taste of the godly powers a Jedi just might have. There is no reserve for the environment around you. Everything gets destroyed. You can also move tons of objects, including the enemies you're fighting. You can flick guys through the stratosphere or just crush them with that boulder. The choice is yours. You eventually learn to shoot lightning and turn your lightsaber into a boomerang, among many other abilities, by the time the game is done. It is rather unique and quite cool. Another admirable trait in The Force Unleashed is the variety of locations you visit. Star Wars has quite a few different locations throughout its universe, and Unleashed does not skimp out. I looked forward to checking out each new area with its unique art design and atmosphere, from the insides of spaceships to a selection of different backwater planets. Slightly detracting from it all, though, was an occasional lower frame rate and some really weird graphical glitches, but it's not really too bad. Alright, it's time to break my poetic style of reviewing here and just give you the real deal. Right now, a crapload of people watching this internet video are simultaneously shitting themselves because I'm not automatically giving this Star Wars game a 10 and hailing it as the greatest piece of software programming in existence. Why are these freaks upset? Because besides being insane assholes, The Force Unleashed does a good job at making you feel like a part of the Star Wars universe. If one were heavily obsessed with the Star Wars universe, they could potentially overlook the gigantic host of tiny flaws and have a really great time. Unleashed succeeds in quite a few areas as an over-the-top action romp. If it weren't a Star Wars game, though, even containing an equally interesting storyline involving characters that had nothing to do with Star Wars, no one would ever really care. It would be known as the buggy little game that could have been best recommended as a weekend rental. So the question comes down to this when you review this game. Are you reviewing Star Wars The Force Unleashed as a device that'll exploit Star Wars nuts and saturate their needs for all things Jedi? Or as just an actual video game with both potential positive qualities and flaws? Personally, to the dismay of half the internet, I'm sure, I'm going with the latter. Star Wars The Force Unleashed is still an average weekend rental to the non-insane. You can crush your way through this in 7 or 8 hours and never look back. It's really just the lack of polish that keeps this game from being memorable, but hey, now that this Force engine has been created, maybe next time around will be even better. I'm sure there'll be one. I give Star Wars The Force Unleashed on the Xbox 360 a 5.5 out of 10.